Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Welcome. Dear student, today I will try to take a class for class 6 to 10 students. I hope it will help you if you seriously attention to my class. So I cordially request you, please download the video or watch the video and try to understand what I want to present now. Okay, student, look at the picture. Do you understand what I want to present now? Yes, someone wants to write a letter. For this I can say he will write a letter. That means she is pretty likely. And this picture shows someone already start writing a letter. That means he already start his writing. So I can say he writes a letter. It's Bengali. She ekta chitti likhe. And this picture shows someone already complete his letter. So I say he wrote a letter. That means she ekta chitti likhlo. What did we mean by that? Yes, today our topic is tense. Tense, that means time. In Bengali, kal. What is tense? The tense is the time taken to complete the action, or the happening time of verb is called tense. In Bengali, kriya sampurno hoar shomoy ke tense bole. Kriya poder gotoman shomoy ke kal bola. There are three kinds of tense, such as present indefinite tense, present continuous, present tense, past tense, and future tense. All these kinds of tense are divided into four kinds, such as present indefinite tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, present perfect continuous tense. Here we see 1 to 4. And past similarly divided into four kinds: past indefinite, past continuous tense, past perfect tense, past perfect continuous tense. It is 5 to 8. And future tense similarly divided into four kinds, which is number 9 to 12. Future indefinite tense, future continuous tense, future perfect tense, future perfect continuous tense. Here we see that tense is divided into totally 12 kinds, 1 to 12. If I ask you what is the name of number 6 tense, you can easily say past continuous tense. If I ask again, what is the name of element? You said perfect tense. So we can say totally tense is 12 kinds. And these are the name of these. Okay, students, why we want to learn English and why we learn tense? Because we want to talk or we want to speak in English. So to translate Bengali to English, you must learn tense. And first of all, you must be learned Bengali correctly, because without making sentence Bengali correctly, you cannot translate any Bengali sentence to English. So first of all, you have to know the Bengali word of the Bengali sentence. Here I say in Bengali, jokhon tumra bangla bakke kriya poder sheshe dekhba shobd kriya poder sheshe roshi antostiyo o e a na itadi, tokhon tumra bujhte parba je eti hocche ek number tense tatha present indefinite tense. Jokhon tumra dekhba bangla kriya poder sheshe cho chi sa se san itadi, tokhon tumra bujhba je eti present continuous tense. So all these are same. তোমরা যখনই দেখবা বাংলা ক্রিয়াপদের শেষে এই জিনিসগুলো, তখনই তোমরা বুঝবে এটি কোন টেন্সে যাবে. Dear students, we have to learn the structure of these kinds of tense. That means we have to learn 12 structure of 12 tense, because every sentence are divided into in 12 tense. So if you want to translate into English, you must learn the 12 structure of tense. So I present a trick to memorize the 12 structure, just 5 steps. So 5 steps of tense structure. Here first of all, you memorize subject, second auxiliary verb, third verb, fourth ing, and fifth object or extension. Subject, that means we write subject both of the 12 structure firstly, and second we write auxiliary verb according to the sort. Here I write this, we write in the number of one tense there is no auxiliary verb, number two am is are, number three have or has, number four have been or has been, number five no auxiliary verb, number six was were, number seven had, number eight had been, number 9 shall or will, 10 shall be or will be, number 11 shall have or will have, number 12 shall have been or will have been. And third step, we have to write a verb, main verb. We know the form of verb is three kinds: present form, past form, past participle form. Here I write present form, that means B1, past form for B2, and past participle form for B3. Here I use a trick to memorize where the verb form we use. The trick is 813. 813 means we write B1 form in the number 8. That means at jagay amra B1 likhbo shegulo hocche সকল জোর. আমরা জানি 12টা টেন্সের মধ্যে জোর সংখ্যা হচ্ছে 6টা, 2 4 6 8 10 12 এবং 1 ও 9, টোটাল 1 ও 9 এ মিলিয়ে মোট 8টা জায়গায় আমরা b1 ফর্মটা লিখব b2 লিখব একটা জায়গা সেটা হচ্ছে শুধু 5 নম্বর টেন্সে আমরা b2 লিখব এন্ড b3 উই রাইট 3 টাইমস অর্থাৎ তিন জায়গায় b3 লিখব সেগুলো হচ্ছে 3 7 11 অর্থাৎ সবগুলো 3 নম্বর প্রেজেন্টের 3 নম্বর পাস্টের 3 নম্বর এবং ফিউচারের 3 নম্বর টেন্সে উই রাইট b3 ফর্ম এন্ড ফোর স্টেপ ইজ ing উই রাইট ing at the ending of the b1 or every সকল জোড় সংখ্যাগুলোতে আমরা বারবার শেষে ing যুক্ত করব যেমন 2 নম্বর 4 নম্বর 6 নম্বর 8 নম্বর 10 এবং 12 নম্বর টেন্সে আমরা বারবার শেষে ing যুক্ত করব and thus object we write object at the ending of the all of all this structure so students remember this five steps of tenses structure is clear I hope now I clear the form of verb b1 b2 b3 that means present form past form past participle form okay students according to the five steps idea we write this structure according to the third according to the trick here firstly we write we wrote this সবগুলোতে সাবজেক্ট দ্যাট মিন্স ফার্স্ট স্টেপ সবগুলোতে সাবজেক্ট এন্ড দেন আই রাইট 12 টেন্স ইজ ফার্স্টলি আই রাইট দিস সাবজেক্ট এন্ড সেকেন্ডলি উই রাইট অক্সিলারি ভার্ব অ্যাকর্ডিং টু দ্য সার্ট দেন আই রাইট অক্সিলারি ভার্ব অ্যাকর্ডিং টু দ্য সার্ট এন্ড থার্ডলি ভার্বের ফর্ম অফ ভার্ব অ্যান্ড অ্যাকর্ডিং টু দ্য 813 13 trick we use this according to the trick 2 4 6 8 10 12 we write b1 and 1 and 9 we write b1 that means we write b1 form in the 8th section and b2 form only use in the number of 5 and b3 we write every third number of the distance that means 3 7 and 11 we write their b3 form and fourth we write ing form there we know we write ing form ing every quiz that means 2 4 6 8 10 and 12 and thus we write object every structure of every ending of the structure and then I write object so students I hope you are clear five steps of tenses structure if you memorize this chart and then you can write this structure of 12 tense okay first of all subject secondly auxiliary verb thirdly form of verb fourth ing and fifth object according to the structure we make some sentence for example ami ekti chithi likhi there it is a Bengali sentence and we know ami is the subject of sentence activity is the object and likhi is verb so we find the verb is likhi here we pronounce e at the end of Bengali verb likhi e so e that means this introduce the structure of number one tense that means present indefinite tense here we write the structure of present indefinite tense subject perfect present form. The B1. Here I write S or yes. I will discuss about it in my next class. Just subject B1 and object here I present. And according to the structure, I make this sentence. Subject Ami, that means I. B1 Likhi. You know the English for English is write. So we write, and then object is activity, and then its English is a letter. According to the structure, I make this sentence. Here subject is I, verb is write, and object is a letter, and thus complete the sentence. If you want to write more than another sentence, you can write this according to the structure. And then we say ami ekti chitti lekhchi. Here verb is lekhchi, and when we see at the ending of Bengali verb see, saw, say, then we can understand this will be the number two tense, that means present continuous tense. Bring to the tense, this structure present continuous tense structure is subject plus am or is or are plus v1 plus ing plus object. Here according to the structure, we make this sentence. Ami, that means I, we have to write am is are, and I choose am, then I write am, and then v1 form is right, and we know we have to add ing at the ending of verb, and then object editor. Thus it is complete. Ami ekti chitti lekhchi, its will be I am writing a letter. According to the third structure, to make this sentence, I have written a letter. Here subject is I, have or has. I choose have, and then B3 written, write, wrote, written, we write written, and then extension or object is a letter. According to the fourth structure, subject have been or has been plus B1 plus ing plus object or extension. Here acquaintance structure, I write this sentence, I have been writing a letter. So all of these structure, according to the structure, I make this sentence accordingly. For example, subject plus B2 plus extension or object, that means the structure of number 5 tense, that means past indefinite tense. And according to the structure, I make this sentence, I wrote a letter. Okay. And similarly, I make this sentence from 1 to 10 to 12. And you slowly, or your mobile or computer, push and saw the structure according to the structure I make the sentence. And I hope you will be understand what I want to present now. However, here we see some of the tense more than one auxiliary verb. We will discuss next class where we use and how to use auxiliary verb. Okay. Students, your homework is write the name of 12 kinds of tense, write 12 structure of 12 kinds of tense at least 10 times, make a sentence with the all of structure. You know tense is a large subject, it is most important for you. So
I made
3 classes up tense. It is my first class. When you see my whole or three class, then you can understand the whole concept of tense, and it will help you much. So I request you download my tense class 1 to 3, and then see the class more and more, and then you exercise at your home. And goodbye. Thank you.